So the federal government has dismissed claims that several media houses have been banned from covering the State House. The special advisor on media and publicity of the president, Femi Adesina, says several people were only stopped from accessing the State House gallery as part of efforts to reduce overcrowding with an aim to stopping the spread of coronavirus. Adesina says reports circulating around that journalists were banned is false and misleading.
Banned is a wrong word. Anybody that uses that word banned is just operating from a mindset. And you know that Nigerians love conspiracy theories, but this one is no conspiracy at all, and there is no ban. What happened is that in the press gallery, you have about 108 journalists in that single hall. And it goes contrary to the spirit of the times. The times dictate that you don't have too many people congregated in one place. Imagine 108 journalists, and if one of them happens to catch the virus, he spreads it among all the journalists. So we said, for now, let them stay away. Not much is happening for now. Let the journalists stay away. But we picked a certain number, representative of the media. They will come in. If there is anything, they will cover. And those outside will also not miss, because there will be a system in which they can share reports. So ban will be a wrong word. It will be operating from a mindset of conspiracy, and there's no conspiracy here at all.
Now joining us live via telephone is the president of Nigerian Union of Journalists, Chris Isiguzo. Thank you, Chris, for joining us.
Yeah, thank you very much. Good afternoon.
Now, how do you react to the news that made the rounds about journalists being banned from getting entrance earlier on?
Well, for us, it was shocking news when we read that some journalists have been banned from covering activities at the presidential dinner. But when we made inquiries, we were given the details of what really transpired, where we were told that a few persons were chosen to be covering activities there, while the bulk of our colleagues there were asked to stay away from the villa. Well, looking at the mood of the nation now, one would have ordinarily said that it's not a bad decision, but we have also looked at other countries of the world that are being terrorized by this coronavirus pandemic. I've not heard of any state house that has asked journalists to stay away from the villa. This is the only place it has happened among the tens of countries that have been affected by COVID-19.
Okay.
So it is not a good development for democratic governance. We are already planning to do a formal letter to the villa and ask them to quickly rescind that decision, because we know that unique ingredients of democratic governance, one is free press. When you restrict the media from its operations, then we are not talking about democracy. So the right thing to do quickly is to rescind that decision and the grant of certain access to journalists who have been accredited to cover activities at the presidential villa.
Okay, now, Chris, if I'm to interject here now, in a swift reaction, the special advisor on media and publicity to the president, Mr. Femi Adesina, said that news is false and misleading, that they were not banned, but in trying to curtail the amount of people allowed in to not further aggravate the spread of coronavirus, some people were not allowed in and not totally being banned. That is misleading information. Your quick reaction to that?
Well, we have watched other places. We have been told to adopt the social distancing strategy. And if you look at other places where journalists cover activities of government, they are kept in packs, not like they are together. We have that 108 journalists are covering activities at the presidential villa. Does it now mean that they don't have a place where journalists can stay again to do their job at the villa? That is not the right thing to do. Whatever defense that they are putting up, I don't think it's most appropriate. The right thing to do at this critical point in time is to allow journalists who themselves have been accredited by the Office of the Special Advisor to the President of Media and Publicity. So why now suddenly, at a time when these journalists are supposed to be up to date with developments at the State House, you now say, no, they should go and some people will be bringing stories to them. For crying out loud, that is not a good defense.
All right. Now, Chris, so just,
as the union,
yes,
as the Nigerian of journalists, we are asking that government should quickly rescind that decision.
Right.
Rather, they should create platform for people to keep self-distance, you know, from one and another, and not to ask them to go. What you have indirectly done is to ask all those media houses that you have restrained from coming there, you've technically blacklisted them from covering activities at the villa.
All right, Chris, quickly.
That's not a good one.
All right.
Just before, talking about democracy.
Yes, Chris. Just before I let you go, Chris, quickly, I need a quick reaction from you. What can a body such as yours do to ensure that there is reliable information available to the common man at a time when right information can be like a lifeline?
Pardon, I didn't get you clear.
I'm asking now, in the light of the current occurrences of COVID-19, what can an organization like yours do, a body as yours do, to ensure that there is reliable information available to the common man at a time when the right information can be like a lifeline?
Well, we are disturbed. If you go to my social media handles, I've been sending messages, and I've asked Nigerians to, before you accept that story that is trending on social media, try to do a fact checking, you know, before you confirm, because we know that these people, agents of disinformation, are on the prowl, and they are disseminating several fake news, fake stories here and there.
Okay.
So as a union, we have made it very clear that do a thorough check before you accept it.
Okay.
And don't accept everything they dish out on the social media. Because
right.
I've always said it, over 80% of what you read on social media don't represent the truth.
All right.
So we have credible platforms, we have credible media organizations that you've got to rely on, and not just what they dish out on the social media.
All right, Chris, thank you very much. NUJ President Chris Isuzugo, thank you very much for joining us and for your contributions.
My pleasure.